Let's take a look at basic animation in 3ds Max. Animation is a series of still images that are shown in succession fast enough to be perceived as motion. In traditional animation, to animate the hand of a character moving above its head, an artist draws two key images called keyframes, one with the hand down, the other with the hand raised. He or she then draws in between images to make the movement smoother, interpolating between the two main poses. When using a 3D application such as 3ds Max, you set keyframes to record the state of an object in the scene, and the application interpolates the in-between frames. Most animation is done on the transforms of objects, basically moving, rotating, and scaling objects. But you can animate most values on objects in 3ds Max, such as animating colors of materials or the brightness of a light. This lesson shows how to basically animate objects in the scene using two animation modes called Auto Key and Set Key. Start by opening the animation _start.max file. To begin with, let's understand frame rates by going to the time configuration. Here, you can see by default 3ds Max set to NTSC or 30 frames per second. You will want to know your desired output to set your frame rate here. We'll stay at 30 frames per second. You can change your frame rate at any time, and Max will adjust existing animation to fit the new frame rate as long as you enable the Adjust Keys option. You can also set your time range to define your start time and your end time, which again can be adjusted at any time. And the playback section allows you to set the playback speed of your animation when you play it back. Of course, we'll leave it at 1x speed. Back in the scene, select Stand Person 001 and press W for the Move tool. Turn on Auto Key. The interface turns red, reminding you that you are in animate mode and that most things that you do at this point will be animated. The timeline allows you to change to different frames in time as well as scrub through the animation by dragging the mouse. If you move to frame 30, which is 1 second of animation, and move the stand person object towards the barricade, Auto Key records the change, setting keyframes at frames 0 and 30 to mark the move's start and end. Auto Key always records from the beginning of the animation. If you scrub the animation, you'll see the interpolation between the two keyframes, moving the stand person 001 object. If you want stand person 001 to stay in place for a while, say between frames 30 and 60, you can simply copy this keyframe. Shift drag the keyframe to copy it, then move the copy to frame 60. The two keyframes are identical, so the stand person remains stationary between them. The barricade would open at this point, and you can animate that in a moment. Go to about frame 90 and move the stand person into the train station. You can turn off the auto key at this point. Take a look at the animation. The stand person moves, pauses at the barricade, and then goes in. However, notice how the stand person 001 accelerates and decelerates. It makes sense that he slows down before stopping at the barricade, speeds up again as he enters the train station, and slows down again before he stops. But there's an acceleration right after the first keyframe, which looks wrong if you assume stand person 001 is coming in at a constant speed. It looks like it's accelerating from a stop, but you can change that by using the curve editor. With the stand person object still selected, open the mini curve editor with this icon. Then click the filter button. In the filters, click none, then select hierarchy, objects, transforms, position X, Y, and Z to make the view a little less cluttered in the mini curve editor. Then drag to resize the panel. The left panel shows the selected animated object and its various transformation tracks. In this case, position in each X, Y, and Z tracks. Click the X position track to view its animation curve. Use the horizontal extends and value extends button to fit the curve to the display. Animation curves show a track's animation as a function curve of the value over time. A flat curve means there's no real movement in the Z position for the stand person object, since there is no vertical change to the values of the curve. Go back to the X position track and click Value Extends to see the curve again. You navigate in the curve editor by dragging with the middle mouse button. To zoom, use the magnify icon to zoom in and out as needed. Lastly, simply drag the yellow bars to scrub the animation. The red, green, and blue curve colors correspond to the X, Y, and Z axis in world coordinate space. In this case, only the X position track has animated data on it, since you only moved the stand person 001 in that direction. The curve illustrates the animation by charting the time and value of each keyframe and by showing the interpolation between these keyframes. So you can see that the red curve shows acceleration, deceleration at the barricade, a pause, then an acceleration and deceleration again. Select the first keyframe. There are a few ways you can change the interpolation that follow it. You can drag a Bezier tangent handle up and down. You can also use one of the key tangent presets to change the interpolation to fast, slow, and so on. Click Linear Tangent Preset to move the object to a constant speed until it decelerates near the barricade. Play the animation to see the result. Next, you can animate the barricade so that it opens for the character. This type of barricade rotates, and notice that its pivot point is in the right location. This time, animate using the Set Key mode, which favors pose-to-pose animation and is a little different than Auto Key. Like Auto Key, it turns the interface red, but it doesn't create keyframes on the fly. In the Key Filters dialog, you can choose what type of keyframes you want to create. In this case, you only need to rotate the gate, so you can turn off everything except rotation. First, select a frame such as 40. Then click the Set Key button, then press K to record the state of the barricade manually. Notice that it didn't automatically set a key at frame 0 and gives you control over each keyframe instead. Go to frame 60, where the person is passing through. Rotate 30 degrees to raise the barricade and set a keyframe. Remember that a keyframe records the state of an object at a given time. So if you forget to set a keyframe and move the slider, you'll lose the change that you made. The barricade should stay open for a moment. So at 75, you can set another keyframe for it. Copying the keyframe by shift dragging will also work. Then, as the character slows down at about frame 90, rotate the gate closed at negative 30 degrees and set a keyframe. Turn off set key, go to frame 0, and play the animation. Save your progress, as we'll pick up in the next lesson from this point in the scene.